Okay, what were we doing again? Let's see our quest. What do we have to do? Oh, yeah, we gotta do our next game. That's right, we were about to do our next game. You gotta do a highlight play, which is like a dunk. And you gotta do, like, let's play our next game. Let's go. Oh, you gotta do some coach drills, too. You gotta do at least 3 coach drills before the game, obviously. To the locker, to the arena, let's go.
I need to find the strawberry.
Let's see if this is busted or not. Oh, the meteor's slower now. That's what makes it easier. Instead of fast. That's gonna fuck you up. It looks like the meter's slower when you put the sliders to 100. And we'd be stuck on the story mode forever, and we don't want that. Want to get it going.
Unafraid to run offense through their picks, Grant. Talk about the value of being able to do that.
Yeah, BA, you know, it just speaks to how...
Tell Brazen! You're going to be with Lonzo Ball, the most controversial person. Because his father's controversial. No, but he's...
Checked in for Williams. Gallinari comes in for Horford. Brogdon's checked in for Jaylen Brown. And it's Brown in for Smart.
That are just too
abusive. Now, if you're just tuning in, we played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. From deep 3-point range, Drummond grabs the miss. Chicago trailing here.
It wasn't your
ball. And Ball throws it down.
You're taller than you think.
It wasn't your range, that's why it was hard to do.
Outside, Brown. Pass to Tatum. The three is up. Good. And Brown gets the assist. Tatum's got 19 points.
He's looked practically.
You got an assist, that counts as a point.
The defense, yeah, well, they haven't had many answers for him.
Back on draft night 2017, the Bulls trading away their star, Jimmy Butler.
And what a haul they got from Minnesota. Zach LaVine, the headliner, and he's turned out to be a franchise player. It's tough to win one of those type of deals, but Chicago got a stud.
Oh!
For Chicago, they've gone 6 of 11 so far. Inside, here's Drummond, and the jam by Drummond.
Monster finish with authority,
and he hangs on the rim for a little extra spice.
Pass.
Williams against Vucevic. Williams passes to Brogdon. Pure from 3-point range. Brogdon's got 8 points.
Love watching Brogdon make the right reads. He's more than capable of converting catch-and-shoot opportunities.
Oh, he got right past you.
The drive. Lays it up and banks it in.
Yeah, their defense is starting to wear down. That's 3 straight buckets at the rim.
Out to the right wing. Brogdon against LaVine. And it's Brogdon missing.
Defense pulled out all the stops to shut him down there.
Pass to LaVine. Brown with a rebound.
Probably should have scored there. He usually does.
LaVine against Gallinari. We've got 13 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Drilled from 11 feet out.
How'd you figure that out? Keep trading the little punches, helper thing.
Both teams in a groove early.
You have to think at this point the winner will be the one to settle in on defense.
First personal foul. Team is in the penalty. At the line for the ball, Zach LaVine. Two shots.
They're gonna stub you out, aren't they? No, you're still here.
A multifaceted player with a strong work ethic.
That one falls, so he hits both of them.
And it's a luxury to have a great shooter like him at the line. Very rarely see a miss.
And so it's Jason.
No, I wouldn't. You did the right decision. If you had gone for that shot, they would have docked you.
29. The Celtics. 30.
Oh, you're back on the bench. Damn it. Oh, you're back. 205. You're the same dude.
You can't keep this going. That lead is going away.
White, and it's Lonzo Ball in for Caruso. So Boston going with almost an entire new group here. Gallinari, he's checked in for Williams. Jason Tatum comes in for Williams. Brogdon's checked in for White. And it's Brown in for Pritchard.
2 minutes remaining in the first half. 2 minutes.
Outside Brogdon.
They want you to go in for the two, I think. Why don't want you to go for the one? I think they want you to go in for the two.
He had his back to the basket for over 5 seconds. That'll be it. Chicago has gone 4 of 8 from three, a nice percentage. Ball runs point with LaVine flanking him. DeMar DeRozan is out there with Nikola Vucevic. And it's Green in at the small forward position. That's the five out there for the Bulls.
That is not a guy you want to allow open looks from range. Lucky for the defense, he just couldn't get it to go. Jason Tatum, still so young. His game's still evolving. Over the last couple years, he's been getting to the line more and more, and that's huge. Guy is just ridiculous. He is just an absolute surgeon when he has the ball. This man is surgical. There is no way to slow him down when he wants to score.
Oh, Gallinari with a steal. 103 left in the second quarter. Drills it from deep. And now it's a 7-point Boston lead. And Jason Tatum seeing his free throw attempts increase. What's that tell you, Richard?
Well, it just tells me that he's playing with more intensity, but he's also playing smarter. Jason's using his athleticism to force the issue. Get to the easy points at the line, tap with your thoughts.
And it's good for two. Vucevic has got 13 now.
Oh, just a clever play by DeRozan. Using the pick and roll to make space for someone else.
Oh, nice shot by Brown.
And he's carried them this quarter, a dominant offense.
So how basketball works actually is if you have to like pass someone, they immediately get the bucket. They can't like hesitate. The assist won't count anymore.
Yes, great play by DeRozan to set him up.
So your pass has to lead directly to a basket. It can't just be like he catches it and points it.
From beyond the arc here in the second. Outside Gallinari, Brogdon from outside, and the Celtics another three.
This defense is getting spaced out. Three of the last.
I just realized your grade's up to a C.
Way beyond the arc.
Ball against Brown, pass to DeRozan, shoots over Tatum, misses with the fallback J.
Oh God.
No clue how he misfired on that.
Halftime.
You don't see that from him very often.
And so it's Boston closing out this quarter with a 7-point lead. And it's mostly due to their superb shooting. They've wasted very few possessions. More NBA on
14 out of 60.
Right after this.
Any chance we could skip this?
Hey, folks. Let's kick this halftime show off by checking out the players of the week. And guys, what's impressed you most about these two recently? And now we look back at the first half. That does it for halftime. Let's get back to game action. Here's Brian Anderson with the start of the third quarter.
And we played through the first half. Plenty of basketball left in this one. And you know, Jason Tatum, he's been really making it happen, guys.
They've leaned on him to provide a lot of offense.
Whoa, what?
And so it's Boston who scraped by with the win. With the late victory, they upset plenty of these.
What the fuck, Gabe? You don't give him one more possession? You just sit up the rest of the game? He contributed.
That'll do it, folks. This is Brian Anderson saying thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.
Well, your team won by 2 points. You got a C, you got 3 points. Attribute reached. New max overall, okay. Yeah, I think that you're gonna have to really. Oh. That's my point's accelerator is just.
Where's
Are the reporters in the locker room?
They usually would tell you, right? Yeah, I would say something was going on in there, Sonia, no. Why don't you check your main objectives and see what's going on here. Money to spend. Overall. Looks like you have nothing in your badges. Alright, so let's check what our mission is. Be welcomed, it would be controlled a narrative. That's a side thing. I guess you have to play your next game. Yeah, see, 0 out of 3 coasters completed. You gotta do that. shit.
We'll get the next one.
Good shot, baby.
Hey, man.
Yes, easy work.
Okay, you still have one more drill to complete. How do you do that, by the way? How do you know?
You hold the R1, then you hit one of the buttons that appear on your head. You hit the button and you pass it.
Right, but how do you keep getting correct passes? Does it just tell you which button?
You see a guy that looks like they're open.
Oh, and you hit the button.
Definitely, there's no guy next to him, and then you hit the button.
Got you. Are you out of drills now? Are you able to play the next game?
Yes. They have allowed me to play the next game. You know, I could just say, fuck it, it's a game. Like, I could do that.
But then you're
what,
just...
What am I playing? I'm not playing the game at that point.
I mean, yeah, you... But then do the stats count, like, towards the objective if you simulate?
Why would you simulate? Like, I don't know,
All right, Tom. I think we need to work on getting you some more points and some more assists.
Especially the younger team.
Cleveland Cavaliers. All right, they're gonna. We're up by a ton. 16. You're regarding Darius Garland. He's he's 6'1". Great.
Oh, yeah.
Checked in for Tatum, and it's Brown in for Smart. On the court for Cleveland, the defensive pair in the post, Mobley and Allen. Garland is out there with Donovan Mitchell, and it's Bussman in at the three spot.
That was not your bench. That's why the green bar is so small. You have to be up close to the three point line. If you do it too far, you...
It's Garland with the ball for Cleveland. It's a 16-point game. A slam dunk by Garland.
Oh, above the rim, Mr. Garland. His teammates are loving it.
And there's one area where the Cavs have been very good the past few seasons. That's the draft. They've made some terrific picks in terms of personnel.
Horford sets a screen for Brown. And the dunk by Horford.
Yeah, we're seeing some fireworks from them already.
Well, what I love is the game plan has been solid from the opening tip, and guys are making their shots. That's critical.
Their IGA they have, and the draft's been essential to the rebuild effort in Cleveland.
And they've been so smart about it. You look at the guys they brought in, Mobley, Garland, Sexton. They nailed just about every one of their selections.
And you love seeing that great Mobile One drive a second time.
And while you can't get it all back in one possession, just stay after it, keep attacking, and see what happens.
Williams has a screen for Brogdon. The Celtics keep it going. A new 14-second shot clock.
That's what we call attacking the glass with aggression and power. Al Horford, the second chance opportunity.
And while we've got a moment, let's send it over to our terrific reporter, David Aldridge. David?
Hey, Kevin, I was able to catch up with the Celtics head coach. He's looking for his guys to put up a terrific performance tonight, especially at the defensive end. He said, we want to use our length and athleticism to protect the rim, make it hard for shooters to get clean looks. This is the first meeting of the season between these two. Guys, we'll see how it comes out.
Appreciate it, D.A. They'll be trying to lock it down defensively. Guys, what do you think?
If you want to avoid a run-and-gun type of situation, this is the approach you need to take.
Well, they know they can score in the half court as well. That's your trouble defensively. If you want to take something away, you have to give up something else.
Down low. Allen kicks to Mobley. On the wing, Mitchell. It's over Brogdon.
Well, you've got to have anticipation skills and reading the floor.
Wait. Oh, that's from early. Never mind.
The field. Celtics. Now a timeout called by Boston. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes.
How does this mode expect you to, like, do anything?
With some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
Brown feeling it out a bit. Good on the three-point shot. Brown's got himself on the board with three there. One of the big talking points with MP, can he make the leap to the pro game? Greg, do you think his game translates?
Skills-wise, he was tremendous in the college game.
That was your fault.
The question is the physical side. We'll have to find out if MP can handle it.
On the court for Cleveland, the 4 and 5 are long and out. Cleveland Mitchell is out there.
Oh, your teammate just fucks you there. Oh, that's not good.
Last game for Boston, they picked up the W against Chicago. And Doris, hasn't it been fun watching the evolution of Jared Allen? My goodness.
It certainly has, Kevin. This guy has proven he is an all-star caliber player. We know he's a double-double machine. He prides himself on hitting the glass. Any center on any team is going to have a problem if he gets near the cup because of his shot block.
You locked out.
He's on the trifecta.
How about the payback here, guys? I do me.
Oh, you love to see the competitive fire. A little bit of pride at stake.
The baseline change. Cleveland moving the ball around. Allen, a screen on Brogdon. The shot by Mitchell, no good.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Brogdon outside. Brown outside.
No! That was right on the green!
By 15. Mitchell outside. It's over Brogdon. Again, Mitchell missing. Brown the pass to Brogdon. Inside. Just beyond the clock. And the layup good by Brown. Brown's got 11.
No assist because you didn't, because he asked you touched it last.
Malcolm Brogdon really worked with the pass. That is nicely done.
And so it's the Boston Celtics.
20 out of 60. Let's go.
Into the break. Their defense has been terrific.
We just need 40 more points.
Right back to the action when we return.
We can skip it. It's fine.
Hey, folks, what a start for Jalen.
I was right there with you. When you were in the green zone, it said slightly early. I was like, what do you mean he was in the green?
A look at the top performers from That's all for us. Now it's time to send it back to Kevin Harlan for the beginning of the third quarter.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to
they
be
did that.
Good.
They cut that this year because people complained it made the story take forever.
It probably has to happen. It's been a clinic out there.
Rubio.
And it's Brown in for Marcus Smart.
Ricky Rubio apparently is here.
Boston leading by 17.
And one thing that stands out about this Celtics unit is their defensive ability. They've got a lot of skill on that end of the floor.
Jason Tatum is out there with Brogdon. Then there's Brown. Then there's Horford. And it's Pritchard in at the two. That's the Boston five.
Well, you love to see Malcolm Brogdon take advantage of that frame, capitalizing in close.
That was a second look at our Mobile One drive. Amazing control on display.
And putting that pressure on the rim. That's what it's all about, threatening with that attack.
Once again, off the mark by Cleveland.
Well, certainly not the best defensive effort, but this guy can't make them pay for their laziness.
Passes it to Brown. Shoots a three.
How? That's green! That is literally on the green! This game's garbage.
Oh, good on the triple.
Lottie, what are you doing?
Enzo Horford will bring it up for Boston. The biggest lead of the game was 44 points. The Wizards on the road to finish the match of this game. That'll be the latter half of this two-game homestand.
Great scorers need easy opportunities to pile up those points. Tatum above the rim and the nice finish.
And it's Rubio. That turn on the Mobile. Rubio's got four this quarter.
Well, there's an aggressive mentality in play. Working close, find a way to score.
Their ability, again, to score the floor.
It did. 21 out of 60. They're gonna sit you the rest of the game, I have a feeling. What the fuck?
Brown outside. Misses there. So it's the Celtics picking up the win. Some good moments throughout this one, but they have the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean,
you got 6 points of
both ends of the floor. Completely under control for the vast majority of the game. And whenever there was a misstep, they just came.
We wish you a safe journey home, and we'll see you again soon.
Oh, you have to make 5 shots in one game.
Yep.
Objective failed. You have to hold to retry.
Oh no!
You need to. What are your objectives?
I don't even know what you want.
You have to do a highlight play.
I need to do one highlight play. I need to do something big. Oh, well. Oh, that's it, guys. This is it. Well, I hope you like this episode. I can do something.
Yeah, you just have to do a dunk. That's it. Just do a dunk or something.
Williams has checked in for Williams. Horford comes in for Gallinari. Malcolm Brogdon's checked in for Tatum.
Dunks are actually not bad if
you're in for Smart. Kevin Love's checked in for the Cavs. LeVert comes in for Osman, setting the floor for the Cavaliers.
Too far, that's not sure.
Kevin Love out there with Evan Mobley. Then it's Darius Garland.
You have to be like behind the 3-point line, but not so far that you can't make it.
Kept alive. Tries yet again. And it's good on the lay-in.
Yeah, that's inexcusable. I mean, the defense must push LeVert farther away from the basket than that.
Brogdon finds Brown. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last time.
Yeah, so it's actually, that was a good thing. That means that you get a ball back. They touched you.
He's battled an array of injuries.
Well, it's inspiring that he's still here. Despite all the setbacks,
not gonna throw it
he's
way over
still
there.
Making an impact, wanting to prove that he belongs.
Stevens has checked in for the Cavs. Rubio comes in for Garland. Boston again missing. The Cavaliers have gotten 7 of 13 shots to drop. Puts up a 3. No luck on that one. And Boston going the other way now. Outside, Brown. Back to Brogdon. Horford, a screen on Love. Brogdon from outside. Offensive rebound. Another shot. And it's laid up and in by Williams.
Boy, I like their
That's an assist.
Terrific execution so far.
Couldn't come up with a much better start than this. They just have to keep it going.
Now here's Love. Really played well against Orlando in his last game. LeVert outside. Just 5 to shoot. No good from outside. Boston's gone 2 of 5 from deep. Right side Brogdon. Williams, a screen on LeVert. Brogdon finds Brown.
That's a 3. No!
The triple.
And Cleveland's shooting an impressive 47%. 6 second difference.
Slightly early, and you were in green.
LeVert outside. Mobley, a screen on Brogdon. LeVert passes to Mobley. And he banks in the layup. Mobley's got 7 points in the game.
And it's not just all of his physical ability, it's his hands. He has amazing hands. Catches everything, never a wasted motion. Rate of baskets assisted, it's a stat I really like. It tells the story of how well you are playing team offense.
And as the first quarter wraps up,
highlights are only dunks. You have to do a dunk. Highlights are like a buzzer beater three or a dunk. That's the only thing that will count.
And it's Brown in for Pritchard. Evan Mobley, he's checked in for the Cavs. Rubio comes in for Garland. Brogdon and Brown are on the wings. Grant Williams out there with Al Horford. And it's Brown in at the point. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. The front office got a lot of blowback when they made MP their first round.
There we go.
Most of the fans have their eyes set on Shep Owens.
I know it was. Hey, was that a highlight real play? It's giving you a replay.
You don't want to alienate your fan base, but at the same time, you have to do what you think is best for the club in the long term.
Fantastic replay we just saw of the Mobile One drive.
Yeah, nice finish from him on that drive. Uses his body well and helps extend the lead.
And the basket by Rubio.
Honestly, I think you should just go for more twos. You've been making the twos so far.
Reliable at noticing when his guys are uncovered.
As long as you're open for
one thing, I'll say about the Cavs, it's become clear.
But if you're open for three,
their front office is not afraid to make some bold moves.
Brown passes to Brown. Low block shot, buries the jump shot.
Assist.
Brown's got this second bucket.
And we talk about the importance of versatility. He's really got it all on the offensive end.
Mobley against Horford. Pass to Osmond. Right side Mitchell. Rubio with the ball. 4-3. The shot off.
You rebounded. Holy shit, you actually rebounded.
They've gotten 7 of 12 shots to go here in the second. Brown passes to Horford. Shoots. And it's Boston scoring again.
You did. You made 5 shots.
Cleveland has gone 2 of 6 from distance here in the second quarter. Trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch offensively. They could really use a basket.
Here's Osmond, defended by Brown. Pass to Allen. And here's Rubio. And he lobs it up to the rim. And it's Allen who slams it home.
Making full use of that reach. Allen able to pluck the ball out of the air for that easy lob.
Down low. Here's Williams. Good. And Brown gets the assist. Williams has got 6.
And the defense has no one to blame but themselves. I mean, they just let him get right to the rim.
That's a great possession. Put your best players in a position to succeed.
Allen. That misses. Would have counted had it gone. And so it's Jason Tatum making highlights for Boston, helping them space the floor. 2 triples in that quarter. 3 for the game. We'll be right back.
You just have to do one highlight real play, right? Honestly, if you can like be open for like a dunk.
Hey everybody, it's halftime.
That's the halftime show.
Rough go so far for the Cleveland Cavs. Ice cold, frigid from beyond the arc. Okay, time to discuss the first half. Thanks for tuning in. Now we head back to Brian Anderson for the start of the.
I guess we'll find out at the end of the game if you failed again.
If you just
you
joined
did?
It in,
it's not there anymore.
Is in the books, one half to go. And you know, Jason Tatum, he's been really making it happen, guys.
He's been so.
That's your agent right there. There she is, cheering you on.
open, all right? Go get them.
Who knew? All you had to do was a crazy-ass layup that it counted. Huh. Thought it had to be a dunk. I guess you could do a crazy layup that counts.
A little under 3.5 minutes off the clock now in the third quarter. Pass to LeVert. Got it. Good job in the low post. 6 points for him.
Willing passers. Unselfish play. You have to appreciate this kind of offense.
On the court right now for Cleveland. They've got Caris LeVert. Ricky Rubio is out there with Darius Garland. Then there's Kevin Love. And it's Mobley in at the powered forward position. Shot clock at 6. Here's Brown. And he
gets it. Caris LeVert. First personal foul. Third team foul. At the line for the Celtics. Brown.
That one's off. And RJ, you look at the road the Celtics had to the finals last year. Man, that's as tough as it gets.
VA, when I tell you, going through Durant and then Giannis, and then you saw the way that the Heat pushed them, and then you see the Warriors in the finals as a reward, that is as tough of a road as you will ever find. And I don't see anything phasing this team now, VA.
Here's Horford, and a great assist by Brown.
Dirty dishes. Wish that would go away so you could see what you got. That's an assist, that counted.
Garland up top, guarded by Brogdon. Outside Garland. Doesn't go for him. Now Boston takes it the other way. Next matchup, they'll be at home against the Wizards. That'll be the second and last game of a quick homestand. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Again, the Celtics good for two more.
Such a cerebral player. Brogdon showing off the ability to pick apart the D in these sets.
Now here's Garland. He's got 13. Mobley outside. Back to Garland from deep. No luck on that one. And so it's Boston in a good situation.
Let's say 29 out of 40. 60. Almost halfway.
Well, it may not be a lot.
Let's see the rest of the game, and they're going to give you some chances here.
So it's a narrow victory for the Celtics, pulling it out for the W.
You remember when they were up 20-4 and then they got 110.
As always, Brown, thank you for coming out and cheering your squads on. We hope you can get home safely and can't wait to see you at our upcoming event.
Yep, you did it.
Some fire content for tonight. You see that game out there? Come on, your boy was killing it.
Yeah, so something. I drafted this based on your previous response to Kendrick Perkins.
All right,
it achieves that personal brand positioning that you're after. Right. Yeah?
Yeah, it looks good for me.
Great.
Hey, who's this guy over your shoulder?
I'm Chris.
Oh, yeah, don't worry about him. We're on a date.
What?
The whole thing.
Dude, I am so sorry about that. Ash, you know we could have done that in the morning, right?
He's fine. He needs to know what he's getting himself into, anyway.
Yeah, it's alright, I'm fine.
Okay.
So are you good with the tweet? Can I hit send?
Yeah, I like it. Sounds classy.
Fantastic. Alright, off to dinner with Chris here. Where are we going, by the way? You know I only drink alkaline water.
I know, right? I called ahead.
All right.
Please leave.
Talk to Ashley and figure out what to do next. Head to Lozo the Crown. Oh, there is media in there. But I don't think they want to talk to you.
They don't want me. Well, love me.
So they wanted you to go to Lozo the Crown at the corner store. I think I read it. Yeah, head to the corner store and talk to Lozo the Crown. I think because we're getting towards the full 5 out of 5 games, we really need to focus on those twos because we've got to get you to 30 points in one game. So I think we need to get you some 2-pointers, and then it depends on how long they leave you in the game. That's also the other problem. All right, corner store should be
Bozo the Clown.
He was at the corner store. He is over at the yellow marker to your right.
What's up, bro?
What up, what up?
You looking good out there, man.
Appreciate it, man. Hey,
I got a nice pick right there.
Hey, I didn't know when I was wrong. And if I was wrong, that's what I'd be doing right now, admitting.
I thought you said I'd never be one of y'all.
Look, it was true when I said it, but this new you,
come
when
on.
The eye spot,
come on.
Whole different dude.
I get it.
You want a Gatorade, bro? I got you.
Why not?
You got that blue one?
It's on the house.
Oh, the worst one. Orange.
That's basic, bitch. Gatorade.
Hey, I got you.
No offense for people who drink orange Gatorade.
All right, cool. So we're going to take this on one, all right?
Oh, one.
Cool. So three.
A lot of blue guys.
Two.
Man.
One.
We got Powerade.
0-3. All right, man.
I appreciate you. Lozo the Crown, hanging with my boy MP.
Yes, sir.
The team's in good hands.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hashtag official team.
You sure?
Yeah, we good, bro.
My man.
We good.
I see you around, brother.
See.
This cutscene made no sense. You've got 6 points and they're praising you.
Like, oh, fuck yeah, dude. Mm-hmm. Oh, wait, you want to be back in the office?
Yeah, Ricky says, meet me at the office. All right, once we have meet Ricky at the office. Find Ricky in the tunnel. There's someone here you want him. You have to meet. Ricky in the tunnel, there's someone here you have to meet.
Okay, I gotta
go. Is it gonna be LeBron James? No.
LeBron James.
Does that be illegal?
Oh, you just phased your way in.
Wait, you think that's not LeBron James on it? I have came back to my spaceship. It's true.
Yo, MP, MP, come here. What's up? Yo, check this out. I want to introduce you to somebody, but be cool, all right? It's Jake Duvall.
Okay, I can see that.
Yo, Jake, my man. Hey, check this out. I want you to meet someone real quick. This is MP.
What's going on, man? Huge fan. I loved doing that Jewel Heist movie.
Can't Stop Forever.
Yeah, let me tell you, that was a fun one. I'm not going to lie.
I love you, Jake!
I love you, too!
Yo, what about that one movie you did? The one guy, what's his name? He did the other movie with the guy, and they were like brothers and like related somehow.
I know what you're talking about.
It was awesome, though, either way.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it. Hey, anyway, did you want a picture?
Would you?
Yeah, absolutely. Come on in. Let's stay. There you go. Looking good. Nice.
Thank you so much.
Hey, you're welcome. I can take a photo for you.
I should probably busy or something like that.
Yeah. They love you around here, man. Yeah, honestly, feelings mutual. I mean, I grew up around here, man. These are my people.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, we know all about that, man.
Like, must be nice, man. Listen, MP. Seriously, man. I've been a fan of this team my whole life, right? Mm-hmm. And I'm telling you, there's not one type of player that the fans are into, right? You could be shooting lights out, a defensive menace, it doesn't matter, because what the people want is just someone who is authentically themselves. Someone who'll do whatever they can, using whatever they got to help the team win.
Wow. You could be a coach, man. You know what? You should play a coach.
Tell you what, I'll pass that one on to my agent. Look, guys, I gotta get back to this interview over here, okay?
Yeah.
MP. I know, man, there's a part of you, right, that just wants to show everyone you can out-shep Shep, but I'm telling you, that's a losing game, man. You gotta be yourself.
I mean, if you say so.
I'm telling you, these people, these fans, they can smell a phony a mile away. You gotta be yourself, and you gotta lay it all out there on the court where they can see it. That's how you're gonna be the type of leader that fans can respect.
You got me riled up, man. Oh, man. Jake, thank you, man.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Just keep working for the W's. Okay. I'll see you guys around, man.
See you later, my man, Jake.
Yeah, you had a couple of questions for him? Come on, Jake, we can walk and talk. Yeah,
Jake Duvall, man, yo, is he not the best?
Bro, like, first off, I've never seen you so starstruck before.
Wait, what? Me?
You, me?
Yes. All right, look, I want to say nothing in front of him, but honestly, MP, look, come
probably
here.
Look that up.
Come here. Look, if we're going to be in front of celebrities all the time, you're going to need to keep your emotions in check.
Well,
keep them in check. That was embarrassing.
Is that Jesse McCartney?
Did you see yourself?
No, did you see you?
Holy shit.
I'm suave.
I'll work on it. Fine.
Thank you.
Oh, he does indie movies. He wouldn't know who he is.
Oh, okay. Leadership skills activated. MBA. Okay, so I need to do so good, I need to activate my skills.
Which means you need to make at least 5 baskets. You have to do a total in your career.
It has to be a total. Like a career total. But I need to do control player. I need to do it within 3 games. Who am I talking? The Wizards? Aren't they good?
They're according to this season, they're 4 wins, 1 loss. You guys are undefeated. No, 4 wins, 1 loss.
Kill me. When's the last time you did yard work?
Last weekend. I had one of those nice rides.
I don't see it.
Not since
Katie. And just do those pass drills again. Because I'm going to get bad. Wow.
Thank you.
Hey, coach.
Over here, gentlemen. Time to get to work. We're getting very little production out of these fast break opportunities. So, we're gonna work on that. Today, we gotta work on getting easier buckets in transition.
MP? Okay.
Your confidence is gone now.
There we go. Okay, let's move on to the next drill.
Was it first person to 20 wins or 10?
Hey, he can ball, huh? Keep it going!
Wait, all he needs a two-pointer, dude. You don't need a three now. We got nine. First person to 10, right?
Thank you.
Oh, good. You unlocked something. Fatigue finishing, that's when you're like using up all your energy and you need to finish a shot. That might help you like.
Come on, game time, game time.
Hey, right there, right there. With the foul.
Come to me!
Watch out, man.
You could do better than that.
Shut up, dude. It's not helping.
It's raining! Alright, you got time to play one more game.
There he is, the man, the myth, the legend.
MP!
Which one did you end up choosing?
I chose four general. Teammates do better when I'm in the game.
Yeah, I feel like Lion King. The 3 game used to be way more easier to shoot.
Thank you.
teammate's ball. He's falling in on your ball.
It's still early in the season, and teams are still trying to figure out rotations. Greg, what's it like to play in a game like that?
Keep doing what you're doing, all right? Go get him.
Stats are shit, actually.
Yeah, his stats are shit, but my stats are shitter.
At the line,
these plays are killing.
Brown at the line with one shot. Marcus Smart and a new group getting ready for the Wizards. Daniel Gafford's checked in for Porzingis. Hachimura comes in for Kyle Kuzma. Martin's checked in for Avdija. And it's DeLon Wright in for Campazzo. So on the floor for Washington. Martin in the front court with Hachimura. Bradley Beal is out there with Wright. And it's Gafford in at center. Brogdon kicks to Brown. On the wing, Brown. Lock at six. Shoots over Barton. And it's
how'd
Brown
that dock
missing.
Go in?
They've been sensational on the backboard to start this game. Always a shame to see a guy like Bradley Beal have to go in for season-ending surgery like he did in 2022.
Now that decision, I think, was tough. But in the end, for the length and longevity of his career, was the smart one for Bradley Beal. Get himself fully healthy, fully physically and mentally ready to get back on the NBA floor and be as productive as he's been throughout his career.
Brogdon outside. Back to Brown. From beyond the arc. Rebounded by Gafford. And so it's Beal who brings the ball up for Washington. 4-point game. Defeated by the Pacers in their last game. They'll try to put that one behind them.
And that was a game to forget. You'd like to find some teachable moments, but I think they'd like to just turn the page and move forward.
Like they're blaming you,
quick,
apparently.
Like as quick as possible. That was a dismal showing, especially for them at the offensive end.
Gafford passes to Barton. And he uses the glass on the lane.
Smart play there from Barton to establish himself on the inside to convert.
And that was the Mobile One drive. Well worth a second look.
Nice take.
The dude didn't even bother catching it.
Still very much up in the air.
Derek White checked in for Boston. Brogdon against Beal. Right outside, puts up a three, and that would have counted, but his shot was off the mark this time. And this has been.
I hate how insistent your my player guy is. You have like an amazing performance, and then all of a sudden he's. Dookie.
Brown is checked in for Williams. Richard comes in for Malcolm Brogdon. And it's Brown in for Derek White. Beal's checked in for Washington. Wright comes in for Campazzo.
By the way, the steal counts, by the way, so you're at 30.
Porzingis finds Beal. Got 1:48 left in the second quarter. And it's Hachimura in the corner. The Wizards with another miss.
Yeah, and you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Down in the front court along with Tatum. Then there's Horford. Then there's Brown. And it's Pritchard in at the shooting guard. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. And Greg, up and down this Celtics roster, so many of their key players were drafted by the Boston Celtics.
And Tatum and Brown at the core, but also credit to their front office. Rare to find a powerhouse built from homegrown talent.
Well, the game's four quarters, and after a tough first half, he's found his rhythm in the second.
Here's Brown, and it's Wright sending it back.
That was just unlucky.
Beal gets a wide open look, and the three ball is good. Now just a 5-point Celtic lead.
But Beal loves getting a little wiggle room and then great rhythm on that three.
Brown kicks to Brown. Fires the three. And the Celtics hit again.
Assist.
Both teams running perimeter-oriented plays that are working.
Well, both of them looking towards the three-point line. And I like to see that, especially when the results are made buckets.
Beal from long range. That shot off the mark. And it's Boston the other way. Coming into this, having notched a win against Cleveland in their last game.
Yeah, and in that one, they were aggressive.
One of five.
But also efficient. The exact balance you're looking to achieve.
Well, easy to be efficient on nights like that when everybody has things going. Let's see if they're still in the rhythm tonight.
About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. To right. And finished off by Wright.
There's a feel that Porzingis has to the game, and the more comfortable he is in these kind of settings, he'll rack up some assists.
There's Brown with the three. Offensive rebound. Horford makes it off the glass. Horford's got his first 2 points of the night.
When you're trying to claw your way back into a game, you cannot allow second chance opportunity.
Yeah, those are
performance from Jason Tatum. He has
33 out of 60 points. Nice.
Celtics. He got into double digits for the quarter with
all right,
10
just makes
total.
Four baskets.
We'll take a quick break and then back
in the
to
second
the action
half.
Here.
Raining them from a distance, they're confident getting open looks. It's just gotten them to a big lead.
Yeah, shooting is contagious, and they've caught the bug. Okay, time now to see how the Eastern Conference
Wizards
is starting
are
1-4.
Take a look here now at Boston. They've been pretty much the team we thought they'd be. They've been kicking into high gear mode every night. I like how they don't take lesser teams for granted. Just a matter of keeping it up for the long haul.
That'll do it for our show tonight.
Four baskets. That's all you need.
And if you're just joining us in this one, first half is in the books. One half to go.
I hope it doesn't go like 4 out of 5. And you
has
like,
really been making
God damn it.
Yeah.
Don't. Yeah, give Tom a chance. Okay, good.
You're doing what you're doing, all right? Go get him.
For Kyle Kuzma.
That man was like, don't be a ball hog. What do you mean?
And it's right in for Campazzo. So the Wizards five right now. Brown and Hachimura up at the four. Wright is out there with Will Barton. And it's Gafford in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Wright outside. The pass to Barton. Five to shoot. To the wing on the left, a three ball. Pass to Hachimura, goes back up. The rebound by the Celtics.
And he rushed that one, no doubt about it. The D. Alice position, you can see the frustration on his face.
And the ball's tied up, so we'll have a jump ball.
Ball violation. Check ball.
Oh, do you know how to do this?
Right with it, picked up by Brown. Guys are looking
for
a spot
ball?
Here.
You're five
yeah,
six.
A cold stretch offensively, for sure.
This game is useless.
Right, the pass to Barton. Back to right. Washington needs to get a shot off here. And that one's good. Hachimura.
This game is really garbage. Working on that hand speed.
This is just straight up
Boston
garbage.
Boston leads by four. In the corner, it's Brogdon. Pass to Brown. And Wright pulls it down. The Wizards shooting not great, 40% for the game. Pass to Gafford. The Wizards working the ball around now. To the paint, here's Hachimura. A shot that time, not on target. Now Boston takes it the other way. There's a 4-second difference from the shot clock to the game clock. Boston again missing.
And guys, you've heard of overpassing. Well, that shot was an example of underpassing.
Maybe they can find a way to establish some rhythm in the next few possessions with the extra pass.
to right. There's the triple. And again, Washington with the triple.
But Will Barton always going full speed. That time finds a bullet pass to a teammate.
And as we conclude the third quarter, what a game neither.
That's a dumb objective. Like, oh, do your fucking leadership shit. Of course, right? Of course.
And so it's Boston scraping by with the win. What a show. The Celtics.
You had better not tell him failed. You have to actually do this.
95. Thank you for coming up.
Oh. Okay. Okay, so
Angel Talk takes daily clip. Ricky sent you. Leadership skills have to be at zero too. Is it within 2 games? Did they say? I think it was within 2 games.
Broadway play?
Yeah, like one of the big ones.
All right, let's do this cutscene.
An interesting bit of news today about the ongoing Shep Owens MP drama. Nate White of the Daily Horn reports that the Boston Celtics have requested MP, their controversial 18th pick, participate in a PR initiative to win over skeptical fans. So no word yet on what exactly they have in mind to accomplish this goal, but JJ Perk, what do you think of the notion that MP needs to win over this fan base with off-the-court activities?
And here we are. It's more evidence of an organization in disarray. The reason fans booed MP is because he's not as good at basketball as Shep. These are some of the smartest fans in the game. You're not going to win them over with a PR stunt.
For once, I agree with you, Perk.
Wow.
For once.
Maybe I should rethink this.
No, seriously, though, I'm all for getting involved in the community. Every pro athlete should give back.
Amen.
That's right. But if this team thinks MP can make the Shep comparisons go away by being a good guy off the court, they're in for a rude awakening. At the end of the day, NBA fans want wins. If MP plays winning basketball, they'll love him. If he doesn't, no amount of PR is going to change their minds.
We're somehow JJ, winning. JJ, for once, you're speaking my language.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And I tell you one more thing. This young man needs to put in work. Leave him alone and let him hoop. Enough is enough already.
We don't know what they asked him to do, so I'm not going to be too critical here, but I agree that basketball needs to be his main focus going forward.
Preach.
If he's going to change this city's mind, he's going to do it with results, not promises.
That was refreshingly cordial, fellas.
Don't get used to this,
man. You got it, Big Perk. Coming up, trade rumors. It's never too soon to speculate, but first, this quick commercial break.
Oh my god, that dude floated down! You missed it.
Yeah.
That dude floated from the sky and went to the...
MP. You got a minute?
If I play with my phone now, I'll do something impressive.
Over here. What's this I hear about you working on some Win the City initiative?
Look, man, I've been meaning
to... I thought I was clear with you. Basketball comes first. End of story.
It does! But I got a lot of people in my ear telling me I gotta do other stuff too, man.
What, Freddy? What did I tell you about him?
I know what you said about Freddy, but just because you don't like him doesn't mean he's gonna disappear.
I told you, you talk to me if he gives you a hard time.
He's not giving me a hard time, Othello. The things that I do outside of the court does not distract me from what I need to do on the court or for this team.
I need you focused.
I am focused.
You are a critical building block for the future of this franchise.
I get it. And I appreciate it. I really, really do. But you gotta really trust me on this one. Because I got this.
Adam's on the line for you.
I'm serious. Let me know if Freddy gives you problems, yeah?
I promise you. You'll be the first one to know.
All right, I'm gonna hold you to that. Give me the... Adam! It's been too long, bro.
Dylan wants to talk to you. Find him in the button. You're wanted in the press room! Here we fucking go. C minus is your potential. Average grade went up to C minus.
All right, let's do this. Who's first?
John Luck is the one who does bad people on the team.
Oh, hold on. What's your question, John?
I was wondering if I could ask you about Nate White's report that you've been asked to participate in PR initiatives by the team.
Yeah, sure.
Well, I think it sounds like a really cool idea, and I'm wondering if you can talk about maybe some of the things you might be doing or some of the things you might be looking forward to.
Do good in the community. My team is putting me in the best position to succeed.
I want to do good in the community. I want to go with community.
Hey, I just like to clear something up really quickly. this isn't just some cynical marketing ploy. You know, it's a legitimate desire to do good in this community.
Okay. Thanks for the clarification.
Yeah, for sure. And to answer your question, there's not one thing that I'm excited by. You know, it's just an idea that I get to use my platform, you know, my position in society to help people. You know, it's always been one of the most exciting things about being a pro athlete to me, at least. You know, so as soon as I got to the league, you know, I made sure I had a plan in place to go by doing that.
And the organization has helped you with that?
Without a doubt. You know, they've let me know that I've got their full support, which I'm so thankful for. You know, but it's up to me and my team to drive this, so I think that's really cool as well. You know, if it was them telling me what to do, I could see why people have an issue with it, but it's not like that at all.
That's great. Sounds like the city will be lucky to have you around, MP.
Thanks, man. Okay, that's it?
That's it?
All right. Thanks, guys.
All right, that's it.
There's people that actually pay for VC points so they can just level up their player to max.
Price for these.
Oh, wow.
What do you get with 75,000? What would you even get? Just to max out right now. Is this the idea? Where it's just like, oh,
yeah, I think they pay 20 bucks and then they just max out their 3-point shots and then they just make 3-pointers like, you know, like crazy. That's what they probably do. You're not gonna spend my $20 just so you
I'm
can.
I'm not gonna spend your $20.
You're not doing that.
What if I brought like a fucking gift card and was like, alright, we're gonna use it for this fucking player. We're just gonna bank it all on here and I'm probably gonna miss anyway. And I just burned 20 bucks. Like, I don't want to do that, but it's like, come on.
I might, you know what I'll do? My next paycheck, I'll pay $20 for that VC and I'll max out your 3-point.
I don't want you to do that.
20 bucks. It's not like
it's my player, right? I don't want you to spend more money just so you can have a chance to enjoy this game.
Oh, so you'd rather earn
If I spend the money, it's me on the line.
Oh, so you don't want me to go out of my way to help you if it's my
I appreciate the offer. I really do. But I don't want you to, like, spend your money for me to suck ass.
Oh, you're scared if we max out your 3-point, you're still going to miss.
Yeah. And then I'm going to feel like an asshole. Because you went out of your way, out of kindness, to pay 20 bucks of your paycheck that you worked for, so I suck. No. I refuse that. They sell gift cards at, like, my job, so I can go buy one of those.
If you really are struggling, you
yeah,
feel
I'm,
like you...
Honestly, I just might do that, to be honest. I just might do it.
You can just put the gift card into the PS5.
Yeah, I'll give it to you, and then you put it in the your system or whatever, and then in your account, and then I just spend that.
Oh, is there a way you could pay with a gift card?
Yeah, you get your gift, you get the gift card, and you scratch off the code, then you enter it into like your wallet. Then the money goes to your like PlayStation
card.
Account.
Okay, so. And then I'd spend that money on getting
yeah.
that maxed out.
Yeah, and if you have a little bit extra, spend it on whatever you want.
Right. It'd be a cent extra, because it's $19.99.
Yeah, $19.99. I don't even know what's, like, the maximum. Or, like, what's the limit I can book it.
Right.
You know, like $15, $25, stuff like that.
We're out of time.
Yeah, that's gonna be my plan.
Oh, you're sick of, like, struggling in the game.
Like, I'm not gonna show, like, I'm sick of it. I'm sick of, like, being, like, a college-level player in the NBA.
Oh, you wish that to start in college, you build up your play to like 70 overall or something, and then you go to the NBA?
Yeah, and the thing that pisses me off a lot is right here, it says college right here. What does this mean? What is this? It says college.
Oh, they left that in from last year. They just never got rid of it. It's, that's probably what it is. They had it last year, but so many people complained that college took forever, so they got rid of it. That's what happened.
But were the players, like, their level, though? Like, they're all starting out like you are?
Probably, but they didn't want to have it anymore because so many people were like, this is taking forever.
Give me the option to skip it, then. If I, oh, no, I'm going. Then, like, yeah. But, like, it's just like, okay, we're going to throw you in the, like, we're gonna throw you in NBA where, like, Jason Tatum is gonna slam his nuts in your mouth. Jumping over you, slam dunking you because you don't have enough defense or, like, 3-point shots to make up for it. Garbage. Garbage. Just garbage.
I was excited for this game mode too because I. But this game mode doesn't let. I think 4 times, maybe 5 times. Peace out.